Here is a quick video on how to get started with Jeuvoir on a Mac computer. First, we go to jeuvoir.org/start. This is where all the instructions are going to be available. And here we are going to just follow the quick start instructions as shown here. The first thing to do is to download a disk image for the micro SD card that we are going to put inside the Jeuvoir camera. This disk image contains all the software that is going to run in the camera. We are here also going to download the Etcher program. This is a free software that allows you to burn the disk image that you download onto the actual physical SD card. So here we just download Etcher and we are now going to install it so that we can later burn the disk image onto our micro SD. So we open Etcher. And on a Mac, we just need to drag that icon into the application folder and the program is installed. We put the correct credentials to install it and that's it. So we are now going to start Etcher. We find it in our application folder. Here it is. So it wants a disk image. Let's just close a couple of things here. So the disk image is the one that we just downloaded. It's now available in our downloads folder. We select it. Now it wants to find a SD card. Here we are just going to use a little adapter and insert it into our Mac. The card is detected. We can just press the start button and get going. Enter the credentials once again. And the flashing process begins. It's going to take a few minutes to write the entire card. There you can see the progress going slowly. Once the disk image is completely flashed, it will now enter a verify phase in which basically we are going to compare what has been written to the micro SD card to the original file that was written to it. This again takes a few minutes. And finally, we are ready. After Etcher completes, we can eject the micro SD card and we are going to put it into the Jeuvoir smart camera. Here are the instructions for getting started with connecting your Jeuvoir camera to a host computer. First, take your micro SD card, which should have all the software preloaded already. Insert it into the camera. See how the contacts are facing you when you insert it in the camera. Make sure you push it completely in so that the card does not stick out at all. You should not be able to see it sticking out. Then take a USB cable. Here we use a Y-type cable. You can see that it has two connections to your computer. You plug in both into two different USB ports. This is to provide enough power for the camera. And then connect the mini USB connector into the camera. When you connect it, the green LED turns on. After that, you see a brief red flash and finally solid red. That means the camera is ready to go. We are now ready to get started. So we are going to here just use the PhotoBooth app, which is included with every Mac. We find it in our application folder and start it. The camera is detected and it's the first one that is being used. Here you can see that the first program that starts on the camera is actually a little demo that includes this small movie, tells you to remove the sticker from the lens of your camera, and it's then going to switch to a live machine vision mode that you can then experiment with. So here is the live video now. As you move the camera around, it's going to look for interesting things in the environment. In this demo, it also tries to find handwritten digits, so you can try to point the camera towards handwritten numbers that you write, and it's also trying to detect faces. You can try to point the camera towards faces of people to see if it can correctly detect them. Here we are going to look at one more aspect, which is how to communicate with the camera over a small command line interface that is included in the camera. For this here, we just use the screen program, which is pre-installed on Mac, and we basically connect to the command line interface of the camera. Once we are connected, we can enter some commands. Here we are looking for information, a help message. We are also going to look at the available video machine vision modes, and so on. There is more information about this at jeuvois.org/doc.